Square ABCD with sides length of 16 unit. E is a free point on the side AB. Connect the DE. Let's take segment EF, perpendicular to segment DE, F is on segment BC. Connect DF. What is the minimum value of segment DF? Hello everyone, welcome to Geometry Plus. Please click the subscribe button if you come to my channel first time. Thank you first of all. It looks easy for this problem but a little bit difficult to solve in fact. Here are two solution ways to do it. The first method, using functions. DF is the hypotenuse of right triangle DCF. And one of the right angles CD is definite, it's 16 unit. So the length of the hypotenuse DF is closely related to the length of the other right angle CF. The smaller the value of CF, the smaller the value of DF. And segment CF is in segment BC. The BC value is definite, then CF and BF have a mutual influence relationship. Let's call BF Y. The larger the Y value, the smaller the CF value. So this question can be turned into what is the maximum value of Y? If we find the maximum of Y and we find the minimum of DF, we say the length of segment EB is X. So segment EA is going to be 16 minus X. Let's figure out the relationship between X and Y. Triangles FBE and DEA are both right triangles. Whereas ED and EF are perpendicular to each other, so we know that angle FBE plus angle DEA is equal to 90 degrees. So these two triangles are similar. We get triangle DEA is similar to triangle FBE, so we get the equation Y over X is equal to 16 minus X over 16. We carry out the transfer merge to obtain Y is equal to 16 minus X over 16 times X. This is a quadratic function, Y is equal to negative 1/16 X squared plus X. Now let's take the quadratic function and find the maximum. We go ahead. Y is equal to negative 1/16 times X minus 8 squared plus 4. So only if x minus 8 squared is equal to 0, the y value is at maximum value of 4. We can also look at it in terms of the curve of the quadratic function in the coordinate system. The vertex of this curve is x equals 8 and y equals 4. We get that at x is equal to 8, maximum value y is equal to 4. After we get maximum value y is 4. Let's go ahead and complete the following steps. If y is equal to 4, so CF is equal to 16 minus y, so the minimum value of CF is 16 minus 4 is 12. In right triangle DCF, we use the Pythagorean theorem. It's easy to figure out what DF value is. DF squared is equal to 16 squared plus 12 squared. That's equal to 400. And then we have the final answer. The minimum value of DF is 20 unit. The second method, maximum angle. It's completely geometric idea. In the right triangle DFC, the greater value of the angle DFC, so the smaller value of the hypotenuse DF is. So we just have to know when the maximum value angle DFC is. What will happen? We can then figure out the minimum of DF. Let's go back to the problem. We go ahead and look for the relationships to angle DFC. Connect segment CE. Let's look at the relationship between angle DEC and angle DFC. Angle DEF is a right angle in the quadrilateral DFC. The angle DCF is also right angles. We get 4 points D, E, F, C above the same circle. With 4 points of common circle, we know that angle DFC is equal to angle DEC. Now we can turn the problem into, in what case, angle DEC is the largest? Firstly, we're looking at the angle DEC's performance in the square. We can prove that when point E is at the midpoint of segment AB, the value of angle DEC is the largest. Now let's do the proof. The midpoint of segment AB is K, so K is going to have to be on the middle perpendicular to the CD. We can make a circle where K points are tangent to segment AB. This circle intersects D and C at the same time. Now we connect the DK and CK. After we get angle DKC, we look at the relationship between angle DKC and angle DEC. Let's see if the maximum value of angle DEC is angle DKC. Let's plot the intersection point, L, of the segment DE and the circle. Connecting line CL. Point K, point L is above the same circle. They have a common chord CD. So angle DLC is equal to angle DKC. Let's go ahead and look at it in the triangle LEC. Angle DLC is the outer angle of triangle LEC. So this angle is equal to this angle plus this angle. Angle DKC is equal to angle DLC, so that's equal to angle DEC plus angle LCE. And the angle LCE is obviously greater than or equal to 0. Its minimum is 0. Let's write down the value of the angle LCE. The angle LCE is greater than or equal to 0. And then we can come to the conclusion the maximum value of angle DEC is equal to angle DKC. And only if K is the midpoint of segment AB. So let's go back to the beginning of what we need to figure out. We move point E to point K, that's the midpoint of segment AB. When E is the midpoint of segment AB, let's figure out the value of DF. That's the minimum value we want. When E is the midpoint of line segment AB, obviously the segment EB is equal to 8, and the segment EA is equal to 8. We already know in the first way that triangle FBE is similar to triangle EAD. By similar relationships, we can quickly get the value of the side length BF is equal to 4. So we know that the two sides of the right triangle DFC are 16 and 12 respectively. Using Pythagorean theorem, we get DF squared is equal to 16 squared plus 12 squared, that's equal to 400. So we get the final answer. The minimum of DF is equal to 20. These are two different solutions to this problem. If you find there is another better solutions, please leave a message in the comment section. Finally, you are welcome to subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. At the same time, turning on the little bell on, you will not miss our more wonderful programs. Thank you very much for watching.